What's going on, everyone? It's me, Marco Hanna from PhoneDog.com, and here in my hand, there's the Samsung Galaxy S5. It's the brand new flagship from Samsung, and one of the interesting features of this new S5 is actually the fingerprint scanner that lives underneath the home button. Now, this is very similar to the Apple iPhone 5S, which obviously has a fingerprint scanner that's underneath the home button, very similar to the Samsung Galaxy S5, and the only difference is you actually... basically the size of the home button. On the S5, it's very narrow. On the iPhone 5S, it's very circular, which fits your finger very well. And you can just basically place your finger on there and it unlocks your phone in a couple seconds. On the S5, you actually have to swipe your finger over the home button to unlock your phone. And the way you register your fingerprints is also very different from the iPhone 5S. On the iPhone 5S, you basically just tap your finger over the home button a couple times and it picks up your fingerprint. On here, you have to swipe it, very similar to the way you unlock it. Now, I only have one fingerprint registered here. You can actually have up to three. On the S5, you have up to five. So I'm not sure why they limited it to three here, but we'll just, I guess I have to use this finger since I put this one on here, and you get a green recognized little logo here. All right, so basically to add a new fingerprint onto the manager, you basically push this little plus button here, and it brings up a little prompt here that asks you to slide your finger over the home button in the center of it 8 times to register that fingerprint. So we'll do my left thumb, and we're gonna just slide it here. That's 1, 2, 3. You have to go kind of slow. Make sure your whole finger goes on top of that home button, making sure it's in the center, that you're not going into one direction. It has to be going down straight. And it is a little tricky, but usually you can do it pretty well here. And that's my second fingerprint. So now if I lock my phone, I can use this finger now to unlock my phone. So let's try it. That didn't work. That didn't work. There we go. Now we got the green recognized sign, and now that is completely unlocked thanks to this finger. Now, I definitely want to see Samsung kind of revise how you add that fingerprint, and also making sure that even if I just slightly go to the left, it would work, but it doesn't always work all the time, especially if you go sometimes to one direction. Now, in kind of comparison, the iPhone 5S has proven to be pretty flexible in terms of how you can unlock your phone, even with your fingerprint. Now, usually I put my finger straight in the center here, pretty straight compared to the iPhone to unlock my phone, but even if I put it at a 90 degree angle, it will still unlock my phone. There you go, basically the same thing. Now if I use a finger that I have not registered before, like my pinky, or actually I think I did use that one, I'll use my ring finger, and it won't unlock. Why? Because I never registered this finger. So it's definitely a little different on the Samsung Galaxy S5. I definitely wish we had a different implementation about how the fingerprint works, but it's definitely good to have it there, and you know, it does work about 60 or 70% of the time. So it's still a very good software, very good security to have on your new Samsung Galaxy S5. So make sure to leave a comment below. Let us know if you have a Galaxy S5 and how well the fingerprint lock works for you. Again, my name is Marco Hanna from PhoneDog.com. And I'll see you guys in the next video.